Testing. You gotta talk loud.
It's been a hard week, let me tell you. This is a story that some of you know, because you've read the papers. On May 7th, 2007, I was attacked by a shark in the waters off of Kiavaku Beach in the south end of Maui. When I tell people this, they tell me about their mother-in-law who got an eel bite in Florida, their cousin who got stung by a jellyfish, or they immediately tell me about someone they knew who was bitten or maimed or eaten by an animal. It seems that being eaten by an animal really gets people's attention, despite the fact that more people die in car accidents. And yeah, I saw Jaws. That was in the Atlantic Ocean. Besides, it never occurred to me that an 18-foot tiger shark would show up on my vacation. That morning, I tried not to look spastic, getting into the water with my snorkeling gear without being knocked down by an incoming wave. You know how. I was gliding in 20 feet of water, peering down at schools of fish, when I felt a sharp tug on my right fin. I thought I had bumped into a sea turtle, but then I felt something bite into my leg like it was a marshmallow. An 18-foot tiger shark had come up beside me, behind me. I kicked and my fin went flying into the air. I was pushed forward at lightning speed. It felt like I was on a freight train, and I couldn't see the beginning or end of the shark. Where the water was clear, now it was murky. I didn't hear Jaws music. I heard my heart pounding. I've been in tight situations before as an open ocean swimmer, but this was different. I try to keep my head, but I wasn't exactly Esther Williams at this point. I was in terror. The shark has rows of teeth, and when he grabbed me, he shredded my leg as he pushed me forward. I saw blood in the water, and I didn't want to look down at the damage because I'd freak myself out. At first, I swam away as fast as I could, careful not to drown or swamp myself with water. It occurred to me that he could come after me, no matter how fast I swam. So I calmed myself down and swam methodically to shore. By the time I stumbled onto the beach, you could look through my foot and leg to the bone. You know, this wasn't a how many stitches do you need kind of thing. It was, I'd seen meat in the butcher shop, in the food section of the market, but I never thought I would be one of the porterhouse steaks. There were huge gashes and deep punctures where he kept hanging on. You know, tiger sharks are one of the big boys on top of the food chain, like white sharks in the colder waters of the California. The operation took 4 hours, and I stayed in the hospital for 5 days to avert blood clots, infections, amputations, or a drop foot. I got the honeymoon suite at the Maui Memorial Hospital. It had a dead-on view of the volcano Haleakala. When a friend of mine came to visit, he told me that when they give you a hospital room with a view, it means they don't think you're gonna make it. But if you get a closet of a room with a view of alleys and walls of the other building, it means that you're on the mend. Well, maybe it was a slow day with the Bush administration, because the public relations woman from the hospital came into my room and said that 40 reporters were waiting to talk to me outside. The Associated Press put my story in the Chronicle, the Independent Journal, the New York Times, the Wall Street Journal, all headlined me with a picture, and ABC and NBC wanted to uplink me into their morning news. Larry King's producer called me and invited me to be on Shark Week. Within a day, I was a celebrity of monumental proportions. You know, we were only trying to take a vacation, my husband and I, but Mother Maui embraced me. Mother Maui can either embrace you or spit you out. Well, she spit me out, but not without a fight. After 5 days, I was hobbling around Maui. Strangers recognized me, came up and hugged me. They told me I was lucky, and they were glad that I made it. Long-forgotten friends from Maplewood, New Jersey, elementary Tuscan school, called me, emailed me, texted me, and friends from Marin called me because they recognized my name from television and the news. For weeks, I was puzzled by this celebrity that I had acquired beyond anything I was familiar with. While lulling in bed, I wondered if Princess Di or Queen Elizabeth ever felt this way. They were just born into celebrity, and I began to enjoy a taste of that. For 3 months, I'd wake up each morning so excited and so glad to have survived. But slowly, I eased into my cranky old self, and my husband acknowledged that there was an 18-foot tiger shark out there swimming around with post-traumatic stress syndrome.